ABC 10 News starts now.
The big beat keeps you rocking in your seat.
How about that? It's the show that helped you find a generation. In the 1950s and 60s, students would rush home from school and they would tune in and dance to American Bandstand, hosted by the late legendary Dick Clark, right here in Philadelphia. And this afternoon, many of the show's regulars will gather at the original home of American Bandstand to reminisce. They'll catch up with old friends and celebrate the release of a brand new book about the cultural phenomenon. Arlene Sullivan, Ray Smith, and Sharon Sultan Cutler are the authors of the Bandstand Diaries, the Philadelphia Years, 1956 to 1963. Thank you all for being here today. Good to see you all. Arlene, let's start with you. You grew up in Southwest Philadelphia. You became a regular on the show. Tell us what that experience was like for you.
Well, we never expected it to go that big. When it went nationwide, we began to become very famous with a lot of fan mail. I'd say maybe 300 letters a day. And I was just looking at that clip. I said, man, what style those girls had.
Yeah.
Yeah, wasn't that terrific?
You look at it, and I'm guessing that the adults at that time probably thought, this is the end of society as we know it. But you look at the way those kids dressed, ties sharp.
Sure. They got the... Exactly. If they had that show on today and their kids were dressed like that, they'd be counting their blessings.
Right.
Sharon, now you never appeared on the show, but like so many other teens, you were a big fan of the show. Tell me how this book came about.
Well, as I got older, I always wondered what happened to my teenage idols who were the regulars on American Bandstand. So I said, I'm going to find them. And through the luck of social media and Facebook, I was able to find Arlene and asked her if she would be interested in writing something about American Bandstand today.
How about that? So social media connected you folks. Ray, you were just telling me during the break, you weren't a regular on the show.
I was an irregular.
You were an irregular. You were an irregular on the show. Were you kids considered to be rebellious? Were you the...
Well, I know I was, because I lied to my parents to go. I told them I was going to the library.
Oh, my. What a bad kid you were.
But I knew they wouldn't be home to see me on air. So I just kept going.
And tell me what that, you know, what the feeling was like among, did every teenager in the city want to be there?
It was a rite of passage.
Yeah.
And the thing is, when you were there, you were at a place that like no one else would be. It was so special.
Did you guys have any idea as this was going on that this was creating a cultural revolution? You were at the forefront of something that was so enormous, so big.
Well, I say in the book we were on the cusp of something, but we weren't sure what the cusping was.
Well, you all look great, and it's so fun to see you. I grew up in the 70s and watched American Bandstand every Saturday, so it's great to see the pioneers.
But we will all be out at the original studios today.
Oh, that is fantastic. Again, the book is called Bandstand Diaries. The Philadelphia Years, 1956 to 1963, and you guys will be out there at the original house later.
Right, and it's available on Amazon and on our website, too.
Here it is.
You have it right there. More information on it, just go to our website at NBC10.com or check out the NBC10 app. Arlene's got it right there. Thank you.
Thank you, Val.
Thank you.
You're the best.
Appreciate it.